Welcome to the world of Wakanda when you Batman.
You ain't from Wakanda. Ain't you from Houston?
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy Carpenter here. We back again. In today's lesson, we're about to learn order of operations. Today, we're going to learn order of operations. But before we learn the order of operations, we need to review all of the operations that we are going to go over and learn today. So first up, we have addition. Our first operation is addition. Then we have subtraction, which is simple. Next, we have multiplication and division. These are the different forms that division can take. Division, division, division. All right, now let's jump right into order of operations. Order of operations, how to solve numeric expressions. How to solve numeric expressions? Well. Okay, it says when the operators are opposites, work from left to right. So we have operators that are opposites. What is the opposite of addition? Subtraction, that's definitely correct. What is the opposite of multiplication? Division, that's definitely right. So that's what I mean by when operators are opposite, okay? So when the operators are opposites, you must work from left to right. You must work from
left to right.
Left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right. So we have an example here. We have 67 minus 21 plus 20. The first thing that I'm gonna pay close attention to is I'm gonna look at the operators. So I'm gonna circle my operators. So I look at my operators and I see that, hey, we have subtraction and we have addition. Well, our operators are opposites. They're opposites. And if they are opposites, we're gonna work from left to right. Left to right. So we're going to solve the problem from left to right, again, because our operators are opposites. So let's try to solve this problem. So I'm going to go 67 minus 21. Okay? I see that 67 minus 21, that is 46. So what I like to do is rewrite the problem. So minus 21 plus 20. Okay, we said that 67 minus 21 was 46. And then I just bring down the rest of the problem, rewriting it just so I can stay in order. Okay? And so I am now going to add 46 plus 20. And I know that 46 plus 20, I'll just work it out for those who probably can't do it in their head. 46 plus 20 will be 66. So our final answer will be 66. Okay, so it's real easy. When the operators are opposite, you're gonna work from left to right. And if you notice, each time I solved the part, I rewrote the entire problem over again. All right, let's go to our next example. Again, order of operations, how to solve numeric expressions. When the operators are opposite, work from left to right. Work from left to right. Here we go. Here we have 63 divided by 9. Times 12. The first thing I'm going to look at is our operators. Let me look at those. This is my operator and this is my operator. When I look at that, I see division and multiplication. Well, those operators are opposites. They are opposites. They are opposites. And because they're opposites, we're going to solve these problems from left to right. Left to right, okay? So, here we go. 63 divided by 9 times 12. Okay? I know that 63 divided by 9 is 7. So I write my 7 and I rewrite and bring down everything else. So 7 now times 12. And I know that 7 times 12 is 84. So the final answer for this problem is 84. Again, we solved it from left to right, and each time after I solve one part of the problem, I continue rewriting everything else. So right here, 63 divided by 9, I knew it was 7, and I broke down the times 12, and I got 84. Okay? Our last example. Here we go! Order of operations, how to solve numeric work from left to right. When the operators are opposites, work from left to right. Okay. Ooh, let's look at this problem. This problem is a little bit longer. We got 48 divided by 8 times 60 divided by 3. Whoa, let me look at it. I see a division. I see multiplication. I see a division. The operators are still opposite. The operators are still opposite. So I need to solve it from left to right. Left to right. So we have 48 divided by 8 times 60 divided by 3. So I'm going to start from left to right because all of our operators are opposite. So we go from left to right, solving one problem at a time, one at a time. So I know that 48 divided by 8, that gives us 6. And so what I'm going to do is bring everything else down, rewriting the problem, times 60 divided by 3, okay? I still need to keep solving from left to right because my operators are still opposite. So I go here, 6 times 60. If you remember the pattern for multiplying by 10s, you know it's really 6 times 6, and you put that placeholder at the end. So that will be 360 divided by 3. Now we're down to our last step. And keep in mind, I'm rewriting the problem every single time I'm solving one part. Okay? So we have 360 divided by 3. And I'm just going to model long division so you can see how I can get this answer. So right here we have 360 divided by 3. Okay? So I know that 3 times 1 would get us 3. Boom. Subtract that. Bring down the 6. I know that 3 times 2 would get us 6. Boom. Subtract that. I know that 3 times 0 would get us 0. So our quotient right here will be 120. So the answer is 120. That's it for the intro to auto operation.
Ain't nothing new to me.